What's going on, everybody? My name is Pizza Hunter Brandon. Welcome back to another episode of ARK here on the ARK YouTube Survival Evolved server. You can see we're actually wearing some pretty cool looking gear. So I did a little bit off camera right now. And, oh. Stop. Don't move. Did not mean to do that. Okay, well, I guess it's a little bit preemptive. Oh, my geez. Okay. Don't accidentally ever press T or very, very bad things will happen. Either way, ooh, is that a... Yeah, it's a Quetzalcoatl I see down there. Hell fudging. Yes, baby. So, I went ahead and did a little bit off camera. You guys can see we're wearing some very, very cool looking new armor. And when I say cool, I literally mean cool. We're wearing... let me pick that up real fast. No. I just want to pick up your egg. Thank you very much. There we go. I think it's a total of 22 Quetzalcoatl eggs, I believe. No, hey, Quetzal. Hey, bro. Are you set to enable wander? You shouldn't be. Wait a minute, hold on. Do I have you set to enable wander? No, I don't believe that I do. No, I don't. Why are you just going all over anywhere right now? Let me go ahead and stop you right here. Thank you very much. Plant you down right here. You're not going to be looking the right direction. Are you good? Yeah, there you go. You're fine. Okay. Either way, we're wearing some fur and flak armor right now because off camera, I went ahead and... What is with my birds today, dude? Just sit down, please. Just relax a little bit. You don't have to be hovering above everything. A little bit of some chaos going up right now. Today's game plan is going to be kind of interesting. So, if you remember yesterday, we went ahead and we broke our wallet for the most part. We spent about 1,800 metal. 1,800 metal on one of those metal tree foundations for the Redwood Forest. And it's a pretty sick one, you know what I mean? It was definitely worth it. However, I had a lot of time to think off camera. And if you guys didn't watch it, I would recommend you do. But I can go ahead and show a little preview right here. The location of where I put it was right next to a metal mountain. And the reason for this was because one of the members of Blue Bantam Boys had already put down one of the foundations by the lake that I wanted to move to. And at the time of recording, I wasn't necessarily sure whether or not it would be cool if I bunked across from the lake or if they wanted to have the whole area to themselves. Because I would have been fine with either, right? You can call whatever you want. You can do whatever you want on the server. So what I did was I moved to a different location, but Miola told me afterward, he said, nah, it's fine if you want to live there. It's totally fine. We can make like a little tree town, right? So at that moment, I'm kind of kicking myself. It's like, well, Miola, here's the thing. I didn't tell him this, but I'm like, well, you know, I kind of spent 1,800 metal on kind of like a permanent foundation. I can't necessarily just move it very easily. This guy's got flying shit today. I can't move it all that easily, so I'm still staying there. And the thing is, the reason why I moved to that mountain was because I was like, okay, I could gather metal easier from here because it's literally right next to there. But then I had the thought, wait a second. Why do I want to do that if I have a metal solution right now in my Quetzals that is so easy to get? Like, I did a little bit off camera. Guys, take a look at what we got here. 303 metal in here. What do we have? 303 metal in here. And then here... 297 metal. You got like a bunch of metal in here. Why exactly do I need to do it over at the mountain? So I don't really know if I'm gonna actually be keeping it there. What I do know though is if I do, I want to be able to gather metal not on air, not over air, but on land. Now, you guys know how dire bears, apologies for the talking, you guys know how dire bears, they're pretty freaking good at carrying stuff. There's one land mammal, conveniently this guy actually has a level up, let me go ahead and level up the weight right there. There is one land mammal that is actually even better at carrying weights than this guy right over here. We can't get rid of you though, man. I mean, like, you're so freaking cute. Mammoths. Not mammoths. Woolly rhinos. Mammoths are the other ones that don't carry as much. Woolly rhinos, though. Those are the ones that are major when it comes to actually collecting resources by land. And I want to start up an army. And my idea is I want to make an army of woolly rhinos. And I want to keep them all at that little base in the Redwood Forest. And they'll be like my metal hunters. You know what I mean? They'll be the guys that go around hunting down all the metal. And I'll obviously do it on foot. But it'd be an easy way, instead of having to take Quetzals on there, just being able to do it on land. And we'll worry about a transport situation later to get the metal back home. But I think that would be absolutely sick. So that's why I'm currently right now in some fur and flak. We're going over to the snow biome today. We're trying to find some woolly rhinos and tame them as well. I got in my inventory about 100 Trank arrows and 400 narcotics. I need to get a few berries, actually. I think they take... I'm pretty sure they take Mijo berries. I think they take Mijo berries. So I'm going to go ahead and grab up all these guys right over here for a little food supply. And lesser to say, let's hop on a Quetzal, head over to the north, and see if we can tame up some, find some at least, and then tame some up. Because this might be a little difficult. I've never fought one, but apparently they're incredibly strong. They can take down T-Rexes, I've heard. So Might be in for something today. I don't know. Also, can we talk about the fact that there's just a wild stego in my area? Yo, this guy's actually, or girl, I should say. This girl's actually pretty cool. I don't know. I like the fact of having, like, stegos in here. We really need to get some, like, bigger animals to roam the area. So at the moment, we got all the big animals over there. We have a lot of raptors, but, and a couple of parasaurs, I guess. But we don't really have any, like, stegos or T-Rexes or carnos. We really need to start taming, like, a lot of stuff. You know what I mean? Wait a minute. Hold up. There's two stegos. What? There's a level 35 male and a level 5 female. Oh, what the fudge? Before we go, I should actually learn up what their saddle is. I'm a little bit curious. They do not really seem like the easiest guys. So let me check. Woolly, rhino saddle, 24 engrams. All right, not too bad. What do you require? I'm actually kind of nervous. Let's see. Saddles here and woolly rhino. 250 hide, 130 fiber, 100 cementing paste, and 60 metal ingots. Okay, that's not bad. We got everything. Yeah, no, we're good. That we got everything we need for those. We can get like 50. Casually 50, we should be okay. Oh, we've laid eyes on our first couple of woolly rhinos around here. Oh, dear. Argentavis, please don't go after me, right? Come on. Argentavis, not the freaking time. Okay, so woolly rhinos are not really going to be the easiest thing to tame. I don't think so, because there's probably going to be a lot of T-Rexes, Argentavises, a lot of other hostile creatures circling the area that we'll have to dispose of. That right there is a level 11 Rex, but let's see. So the woolly rhinos, I do want to prioritize higher level ones for sure, though, even though that might not be a good thing. Now, mammoths, on the other hand, right? Those guys are not really what we're looking for. We need the rhinos, which seem to be, these are, oh, who are they fighting? Rhinoceros, and oh, it's a level 73, but it's really hurt, and there's dire wolves. Oh no. Oh, this isn't good. Oh shoot, I want to tame this one in particular. Okay, we need to kind of watch out though, because we really do not want there to be any gigas. Okay, I need you to be on passive so you don't get hurt, and I do not really care if you follow me or not. There's a lot of these guys around here, huh? Okay, so you're hurt though. I don't really know if I want to, like, tame both of you. I just want to prioritize the level 73, if that's, like, mean. I don't know. That might be a little bit judgmental. Okay. Let's just go ahead and, I guess we might as well take the, oh, yeah, the pelt from these guys. Yes! Yes, we need the pelt. Okay, hold on. Let me go ahead and just, chop these guys up a little bit here. Direwolf, get that pelt. 20 pelt. Beautiful. All right, 30 pelt, 32. Yes, thank you so much. Woolly rhinos, by the way, are... Oh, fudge sakes. Dude, get off my Quetzal. Get off my Quetzal. Why are you running so... Okay, hold on. Quetzal. Hold on. Yo, lag? A little bit of lag there. Yo, these guys are fast. Wait a minute, what? Fly there. Holy fudge, dude. Those things push my Quetzal away fast. Damn, okay. So these guys are pretty huge. These direwolves are a really huge threat. Okay, we need to dispose of all direwolves before we can do anything in this. Oh, that's difficult. And there's also a T-Rex up there from what I can see. This is a really interesting game that we're playing right now. That's the level 8 rhinoceros. Where's the level 73? I think I lost it. Did I lose it? Please don't tell me I lost it. Where is it? It was somewhere around here, right? Don't tell me it died. It didn't die, did it? Oh, it couldn't have. The snow is a harsh place, dude. This is not going to be fun. Is this the level 73 right over here? It is. Okay, cool. So this is the location for the level 73. Before we do anything, we just need to make sure that there are no wolves around the area, because those guys are very, very bad. Kind of actually making me want to tame, like, some wolves up for, like, defense? That'd actually be kind of cool. All right, let's just rock this, I think. We'll be fine. Woolly rhino's right over here. It says, let me check the taming real fast on how many we will need. For, like, a level 75, it'll take about 21 Trank Arrows. Oh, this might be difficult. Okay. It's already kind of hurt, though. Let's just do it. Wait, no. Oh, no. That's not good. Quetzal. Get back here, please. Come on, Quetz. Oh, Quetzal. Come on. You're not that dumb. Okay, I think I'm going to try taming it from up top the Quetzal right over here. So here we go. Headshot. All right. And the tame has begun. And do they... Wait, no. Okay, yeah. I was going to say, please don't tell me they run away from me. Oh, no. The wolf. Oh, okay. He'll be fine. Oh, yeah, the wolf's running. Yeah, no, the wolf's running. It will be okay. We can actually go ahead and shoot it in the meantime. I think we'll be all right. Okay, let's keep following it now. Keep following it up. That wolf has got to be dead, right? That wolf's running away. Yeah, that guy's dead soon, right? Right? Please tell me. Hey, wolf, get out of there. Oh, no. Hey, wolf. Okay, thank God. Wait. Yes. Oh, God, no. Oh, God. I just did a very bad thing. Oh, no. Oh, these guys hurt a lot, actually. So I gotta be really careful right now. Quetzal, give me up. Give me up, Quetz. Leap. No, I couldn't get it. I have to kill this guy, I think. I think I have to kill this guy. Oh, no. Oh, no. I'm dead. Oh, my God. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, no. Oh, no. I'm gonna die. I'm actually gonna die. I'm straight up gonna die from this dire wolf forever here. I'm gonna die. I'm gonna die. I'm gonna die, maybe. Ah, I died by the woolly rhinoceros. Oh my God. That was the dumbest thing I think I've done in a while. Oh shoot. I think we'll be okay. We should be fine, right? North zone. Where's the best north zone to spawn at? I guess right over here. Yeah, probably. Wow. Okay. That was not smart. That stuff happens when you try and prioritize the life of, that was not my Quetz, right? That was me? I think that was me. I don't think that was my Quetzal. If my Quetzal dies, I'm gonna be outraged, but I think we're fine. Yeah, see, the thing was, I could have killed the woolly rhinoceros there and I would have been fine, but you don't do that. You don't do that. Plus, those guys are really strong. Like, they take down a lot of your health. They're really, really fierce creatures. The only problem, though, is that I need to get back over to where I was, and I have nothing on me. Oh, no. let's go back home, grab a pterodon, and fly back over. Good idea? Possibly. Where's my body? Where did I die? That's what I need. Oh, is that my bag? Oh, that's my bag. Okay, cool. Just casually right next to all the T-Rexes and stuff. Let's go in and get it, because why? I'm an idiot. All right, decomposes, item cache. Can we take this right now, please? Take all from inventory. Yes, thank you. Nope. Not what I need. What am I being hit? Oh, okay, a T-Rex obviously is going after me. Obviously a T-Rex is going after me. I gotta kill him. Oh no, Arzy, no Rittooth. Wait, no, it's a wild one. Never mind, Rittooth's fine, Rittooth is fine. We got a Rex, we got the Rex, Rittooth. Oh my God, oh, I thought the, oh my God. Oh, I was about to be so tilt. I actually genuinely thought, where's my Quetz? Quetzal? Quetzal? Quetzal, you're fine, right? Where are you at? I told the Quetzal to stop. Where's the Quetzal? I think the Quetzal went off and did its own thing. I hope so, at least. I didn't get any notification that the Quetzal died. So I think we're fine. Right then. Where is the, right, so we got everything that we need. We got everything. We're good. We are fine. We're pretty weighed down on our Argentavis right now, and I need to figure out where my Quetzal went. Where doth Quetzal go? Where did Quetzal go? Quetzal? Quetzal? Quetzal, Emerald. Where are you at, Emerald? Time to check back in the recording and make sure my Quetzal didn't die. So, my Quetzal flew off some way this direction. The question is where? Please don't tell- What are you? Ah, it's T-Rex, thank God. I was about to be like, please don't tell me that my Quetzal just got pwned by a an Argentavis. That would be terrible. Where did my Quetzal go? Okay. Regardless, I don't know where my Quetzal is. I genuinely do not. I think it's fine, though. I'm pretty more than certain that it's fine. We're just gonna go and take the raw prime meat. Thank you very much. What are you being hit by? I actually really do want to find my Quetzal, though, to be fair. Oh, God. Where's my Quetz? Quetzal! Emerald! Come back to me, please! Ah, there she is. Quetzal, how you doing? Yeah, you're doing fine, right? Come on, come back to me. You're a little, you just got like one little dip in you, huh? All right, come on, come back to me. There you go, you good? Yeah, you good, Quetzal. How you doing? Yeah, you're doing great, aren't you? I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. All right, here's the game plan. I'm gonna fly Rittooth back, we're gonna go back on my Quetzal, and we're gonna start this over. So the chances that the woolly rhino did not die, very slim. Very, very slim. Because I think when I went in to save it, it was actually really bloody, like really bloody. So I think, unfortunately, that level 73 or level 70, yeah, it was level 73. I think that one, unfortunately, is a no-go, which really blows. Yeah, I'm not seeing it around here. Don't really think it's worth the time to keep looking. All right, well, that was an unfortunate series of events. I guess we gotta go and find another then. Hopefully about the same level. I mean, we've been finding some pretty high-level dinosaurs lately, so it shouldn't be too hard. I hope not. I am really kicking myself because I completely forgot out of all of this that you could just pick them up. I could have just taken this guy to a safe place and you would have been fine, but unfortunately I'm not that intelligent and I didn't really think about it at the time. So we'll know that for future if any of them do get into some pretty sticky situations. That guy was only level 23, not gonna worry about him. We do want to prioritize higher level of these guys so I don't waste too many of my narcotics and too much time. Oh yeah, here we go, level 70, perfect, okay. So we got, all right. So what I'm thinking, actually, you know what? If we just hop on our Quetzal right now, and we just fly back home and tame it there, doesn't that work? Like, can't I just take this level 70 and just drop it in anywhere, really, that's not here? Like, not in my house, or not, like, in the island, obviously, but, like, in the north zone by the beach? Can I just do that? Because I'm pretty sure I can. I need to watch the stamina on this guy. But, I mean, I think we should be able to easily tame it that way. At least I would hope so. Unless you can't have them in climates that aren't the north. But I'm pretty sure... Or the snow biome, rather. I think we're okay, though. So, yeah, I'm pretty sure I can just bring it over to the front and we'll be alright. Let's try that. Alright, so let's give it a try, then. We'll go ahead and drop it off right here. They don't take fall damage, so you don't gotta worry about hurting it at all. Let's pop our Quetzal down. I guess just kind of right over by safety, I would say, would be the best part. Or maybe actually, no, you know what I need to do? I need to tame him from my Quetzal, so I need to actually shoot him while I'm on top of my Quetzal. So let's go ahead and just land down right there, and then I think we should be okay in just doing this. Yeah, this should work. I don't really see why it wouldn't. Are we okay? Yeah, we're just good to just tame it from here. Okay, sure, why not? Cheap, easy tames? I'm fine with that. Wait a minute, what? It ran and it's... Wait, guys, what? Wait, what? Wait, where... What? Where did it go? It was... aggroed on me and just... vanished? Wait, what? Hold up. Where the F did it go? Did I do something wrong? Is this my fault? Did it run off to the beach? No. Can you not tame them outside of snow biomes? No. Is it right? Wait a minute. What the f- How did you get here? How did you get there? What the hell? So he didn't like vanish, but he basically vanished. Okay. Sure, dude. Yeah, no, that's fine. No, don't worry about it. Trust me, I'm completely okay with your sorcery. That's okay. Believe me, that's fine. If you can do me a favor and just, like, stay put here, and I'm gonna keep the camera rolling so you guys can see if anything weird happens. You do run. They do run, right? But this guy just vanished before, which is really odd. Did we knock him down? Still haven't knocked him out, though. Oh, don't go into the water, please. Don't go into the water. You're gonna run for a little bit. I know you're freaked out. I know you're freaked. Where you at? You just down there? You just down there? You're just gonna freak a little bit? Yeah, he's gonna freak. Oh, don't go into the water. Oh, go in. Nah, come on. You're making my job much more difficult. I don't like this. I gotta pick you up and stuff. Why you gotta make me do this, dude? Really not the easiest tame I've ever had in my life. Like, this dude is just, like, doing nothing but trying to run into the water and drown himself. Does he really not like me that much? Is that why he's just running? Oh, wait, is he running back into the snow or something? Like, does he want to go back to the snowland? Maybe. I don't actually know what's going on with this dude. He's a little freaked out, though. I mean, I would be, too, if I was trying to be tamed by someone that I didn't know. Okay, then. Could I maybe just do a little jump shot on you right there? Nope, missed completely. You seem to be stuck in a mountain, though, so that's fine. Shot right there. Another shot right there. There we go. And we get it? Got it. Okay, cool. That was a little bit odd, but nonetheless, we got the rhino down, so I think we're okay. In a very safe area, I might add. So, let's check up on you. Level 70. Alright, so hopefully the taming efficiency should be at 100%. Let's go ahead and drop in some Mio berries right in there. Raw meat, obviously, you do not eat. And then we'll drop in a little bit of narcotics, I guess, for later on. Tabor's at 3,000, so I mean... this should hopefully be, it might be a pretty long tame, to be fair, though. I guess it might actually be a really long tame. This is going to be a long tame. This is definitely going to be a long tame. Look at that taming meter. That is something. That is really something. Kind of really wishing that we had the kibble for this, but the kibble that we would have needed is Terror Bird kibble. Now, Terror Birds, actually, if you guys don't know, their spawn was buffed in the new version, basically. They actually fixed it, though, but they haven't fixed it on our server yet. It requires another update. I think it's like version 0.5 or whatever they got fixed. We're on 0.2, so we don't have that fixed yet. But you guys remember the little chaos I had with a few Terror Birds and how there was a plentiful amount of them? Yeah, that got nerfed a bunch because there was a problem. Now, here's the thing, right? I'm almost tempted to, like, go back out to the north, like right here, and bring back another while this one's just unconscious. Because this is a very safe area. Nothing's going to hurt it. Nothing is going to hurt it. That Oviraptor over there is probably the closest thing that would ever lay a finger on it. And it's nowhere near. I think we're going to go back into the snow biome and find another. Let's do that, shall we? Bringing back a level 35 right now, hoping that the one that we kept unconscious is not woken up. I don't think that he would have. Please tell me that she didn't. Please tell me she didn't. No, okay, we're good? Yeah, we're fine. I think that's it right over there. Yes, it is. Now, there's a red beacon drop, which really sparks my fancy, right? I'm really curious about that red beacon drop, but let's go ahead and check real fast here. These guys are neutral, so I don't gotta worry about it. Let's check and see how you're doing on Topor. You are... Oh, no, you're... Why was I even worried? Why was I even worried? Okay, what we're gonna do then is we're actually gonna go ahead and try getting this red beacon drop, coming back and then taming the second woolly rhino. I don't even know if I'm gonna be able to make this red beacon drop because it's been on the down position for a while, so it might disappear when trying to go for it now. Let's pray that it doesn't. Wouldn't be a red beacon drop if it wasn't guarded by something. Fudge sakes, that's not what I need right now. All right, Quetzal, you're gonna have to let me down right here. Let me down, I'm gonna make a run for it. You ready? You ready? I'm making a run. Gotta make a run for it. I'm gonna get attacked. I know I will. Axis take all. Oh my god, it was for a freaking catwalk. All of this for a catwalk, but why? Okay, so the woolly mammoth over there seems to have just ran off just over to the corner, so that's fine. Should be able to shoot it from on top of the Quetzal. It's level 35, so it's not as high level, but it's still pretty good. Like, a level 35 is fair. You know what I mean? It's a fair price. Didn't really know how much time I had to look for one either way, but at least now I know that I'll have a pretty good amount, right? You are just gonna... Don't go into the ocean. Oh, no. You're actually not too deep in the ocean right now, so you're fine. I can keep shooting you. Maybe? I don't know how deep I want to get you in the ocean right now. You okay there? Alright, let's go ahead and pick you up and move you over real fast. I don't want you drowning. Don't drown. Don't drown, please. Don't hurt him. Don't hurt my dude. Don't hurt my Quetz. Quetz Topor is actually showing up. Why? That's weird. Why is Topor showing up? That's strange. Sup, Rhino? Sup, Rhino dude? How you doing? This is a really overpowered spot, by the way. Hope you're doing great, because I'm doing fantastic. Can I shoot your horn? Oh, nope. That's my Quetz. That's my Quetz. Don't want to do that. And we're about to fall? We're about to fall. Oh, just got caught. Just caught on. That would have been bad. All right, and you're running off, and you're going to be down right about here. One more shot, maybe? One more shot. There you go. Alright, so you're down to... Sweet. Why is the noise not going out? No noise. Alright, there we go. The music kept playing, and I'm like, what's happening? That's not good. Wait. What's happening? Oh, I don't like that. I don't like it when the music plays and there's no reason for it to. That's not a good sign. Okay, either way, let's drop in 100 of those and 2 of those guys. Let's check up on our other little inmate over here. How you doing? You are, how you doing? Not doing too bad. 30%, oh, the taming efficiency goes down so low though. Holy crud. Doesn't really matter that much. I think we'll be okay. It might be the fact that we're taming it in the heat. That might actually be a reason why, because this is going to go down quite a bit, I would say. Either way, let's go ahead and give you some narcotics right now. So you're both doing fine. You have 4 sacks of Mio Berry, so you've got enough food to last you through. You've got 2 sacks of Mio Berry, you should be all right as well. Your unconscious Mio is going to go for a little bit. I'm going to go ahead and remote use 5 of those on you just to start off. But yeah, let's go get another. We're just gonna get a few of them, you know what I mean? Okay, so it took a little bit, and by that, I mean a lot of bit longer to find our third woolly rhino. I'm really hoping that neither of the guys that I've downed are awake, and it doesn't look like they are. Oh, wait. Was that just it loading in, or is it awake? Wait, is it awake? Hey, lag. Lag? A bit of lag, maybe? Oh, wait, no. Yeah, just a little bit of lag. So you're still unconscious, and then where's... Okay, they're both still unconscious. Amazing. Okay, cool. Ooh, there's a shark there. Okay, gotta be careful. Let me just go ahead and drop this guy down right over there. You're gonna be peaceful for me. Thank you very much. Looking great. You look beautiful. Has anyone ever told you that? You look beautiful. All right, you're unconscious, but you're still doing fine. What about yours? I know your torpor is gonna go down a lot faster, right? Oh, yeah. No, they're both still fine. 31% effectiveness. That has to be because of the weather. Or the climate, I should say. And then you're like, yeah, 83%. This thing's gonna be like, what, 60% by the time we're done? It's ridiculous. Anyways, let's go ahead and snatch this guy up right here. Whoop! Don't need to get killed by a shark, my dude. Also, please do not get angry at me. It's really not what I need right now. I just want to be your friend. I just want to be a friend. I just want to be a little, you little friend. Alright, why are you running? Why are you running? Get mad at me, dude! Oh, is he going for the shark? Oh, fudge that. No! Rhino, you're not this intelligent. Rhino, stop humping the water. Stop it. Dumb rhino, dude. Fudge off, rhino. Come on, man. I'll tame you up here if you want me to. I will tame you up here if you make me have to. All right, come on, come on, come on. All right. And get it out. Drop him down. Where's he going? He's got to run back, right? Where's he going? He's running back? Where's he at? Is he underneath me? No, he already vanished into the water, didn't he? Wait, no, he's underneath the whole time. He was underneath me the whole time. Are you kidding me, dude? Are you kidding me? All right, here we go. Let's get a shot on before he goes into the water. Before he goes into the water. Shot! Oh, I was like in midair. Did I even hit them? I don't even think I did. Get him in the water. Get him in the water right then. Got one shot. Get two. He's not in the deep water. Oh, god damn it. Come on, Quetz. He's gonna die. He's gonna die. He's not that smart. He's gonna die. All right, this dude's on really low health, actually. He is on really low health. I still need to try to- oh my god, he's so bloody. He is so bloody. If I shoot him with arrows, it might actually kill him. Oh no. This ain't good. He's a little bit of a dumb one, this guy is. This one's a bit of a dumb one. He's gonna run to the ocean. I wanna like chill with him right here until he like heals up a little bit more and then like shoot him maybe once or twice. That's what I'm gonna- you know what? I got an idea. Okay, here's what we're gonna do. Let's go ahead and drop him off right here. We're gonna shoot him one more time. We're just gonna shoot him one time. We're gonna get one shot on him. Oh, he's gonna he's actually hurting my quets. Okay. You really are not the smartest guy in the book, are you? Well, maybe you are. Maybe you're smart and I don't know it. Ooh, I do not want to follow my quets right now. That would not be ideal. Where are you, dude? Oh, he's actually in a position where I can't hit it. Oh, whoa, whoa. Don't fall, don't fall, don't fall. Where's the rhino? The rhino just sitting over here? He's just chilling. He's like, oh no, I forgot you were shooting at me. I'm suddenly not mad at you anymore. All right, shot run right there. And we'll get another. Are you just gonna charge at me from where? All right, there you go. Okay, get up, get up. There you go. He's so bloody. He's so bloody. He's so bloody. It's ridiculous. Is he gonna fall? Oh no! Stay away from the ocean, you dumb creature. You absolutely dumb creature. Hey, there you go. There you go. There you go. Yeah, that's fine. That's perfect. All right, come on. Let me get that reload, please. Perfect. And shot down. Got him unconscious and didn't kill him. Oh, what a great day it is. Wait, did I kill him? Don't tell me I did. Oh, it's a compy. What's up, comp? What's up, compers? What's up, chompers? Compers? Wait, you're not a compy. You're a Dilo. What's up, Dilo? Why are you over here? Why do you exist? Are you unconscious? Please tell me you are. We got them. Wait, no, no. Hey! Fudge out of here. Both of you. Fudge out of here. Oh, the freaking blindness, dude. Really? What's your... oh, my God. He's at 32 health out of 600. That's incredible. All right. Mio Berry's going out. We're going to stack those guys up right there. You are really hurting, aren't you? Yes, you are. I want to actually wait and see here. Taming effectiveness. What are you at right now? Let's see. So, taming effectiveness. So, this guy should be at it. Oh, wow. No, we did hit him once. 87.7%. I think that might have been one of the swings I just did on the pike there. All right. Well, I mean... they're just more difficult. They really are kind of tedious to tame, but I think we're fine now. It's really just a waiting game. Really just a waiting game. This guy's at half done, and it's been a while. We'll remote use maybe, I don't fudging know, like 25 should be fine. I'm not really too phased about losing narcotics. It's whatever to me. And then what about you? You are sitting at half. You're sitting at half as well. Let's go ahead and drop down. Ooh, we're going to have to drop a lot on this guy. Is that going to be enough? 20 right there. Hopefully that should be fine. Might need a little bit more. We're okay. I'm actually kind of really glad that I went out and I tamed them in a pretty safe area. Because I went out, I got myself a plate of spaghetti. It's leftovers from last night. I got like a few different meals and stuff. But it's really good. So I'm going to eat this while I'm waiting for the tame to finish. Because I'm hungry and haven't eaten yet. So It's a good day. It's a good day for Brandon. So guys, looking like our first woolly rhino is about to be tamed. There we go. You tamed a woolly rhinoceros. Hot damn right there. So the tame late whatever the hell even that is. Diet, herbivore, temperament, friendly. Okay, very, very cool. We're not going to read through this dossier right now. So over on the left side here, apologies for my voice. I am in the middle of eating food. I must admit, not the most professional recording. I've got the random name generator up to the left of me because I feel like I want to do that. So first name only. We'll do either for gender. Surname, actually, I like doing either for gender, despite the fact that these guys actually do have genders. That's probably a bit strange, but I don't know. Now, category shoes, we'll go ahead and do English, and then let's just go and generate a name. Gonna be named Charlene. Is this a female? I hope it is. I really hope it's are you a female? You are, let me see here. You are a male. Charlene the male. You know what? Like I said before, there's names that people can have that are kind of like unisex, you know what I mean? Even though some, obviously, are a bit more inclined to one. Why are you over there? I tell you to stop and you run that far away from me? Dude, come on. Now it's raining. Like, fudge sakes. Can I, like, get you to follow me, please? I need... Okay, yo. What's up, my dude? How are you doing? All right, let me go ahead and pull you over. Come on, CBT. Let's go. Come on. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. All right. And now, so how are you doing on your team? So this guy's nearly done. I believe the one over there is halfway done, a little bit more probably right now. So we're working up a little bit. You are a level 41. Not too bad. So yeah, this guy right over here, let's take a look at the stats. 840 base weight. Wow, it's incredible. 222.6%, pardon me, movement speed, and 183.8% melee damage. That's not too bad at all. The health is 1400. That's really impressive. I'm really curious to see what... Okay, let's just check right now. So the weight already is base 870. That's before any of the additional levels get added in. So I'm very curious how it's going to go. I am a little bit disappointed, though, that the effectiveness has dropped all the way down to 70%. That really, really sucks. But still, look at this dude. Holy damn. That horn, though. That horn, though. They actually have an attack, by the way, called charge. I'm not sure how you do it, but if you charge at someone, it can take down a T-Rex. So, I mean, these are some pretty impressive animals. Okay, so our big woolly rhino right over here, the level 70, about to be a level 93. All right, so that one is fully tamed. Let me go ahead and get the random name generator up on here again. So let's generate another name, and we're going to get... I don't know how to pronounce that one. Heidi, I see it is. Okay, so it's Heidi. Very, very interesting name right there. Spelled out like this. So, Heidi. All right, that's fine. Not really ever heard of that name before. I probably have, actually. But let's check the stats on a level 93. What do we got? 960 weight on base. That's incredible. The movement speed and the melee damage all seems to be about the same for the level increase. At least that's just how I've seen it around here, but that is just mad right there. I've already leveled up this guy once, so he's already at 873 weight. That is incredible, though. Holy crud. So we already got two. Now it's time to wait on our third and final mammoth over here. How you doing? I got, well, not I'm going to say it so many more times. Woolly Rhino, you are actually nearly done. Cool. So you're only going to get up 11 levels, unfortunately. So I'm not really sure what your stats are. You are already at 870 weight. So I mean, like, that's actually, for a level 32, 870 weight. Like, hold on a second. This guy over here is 873 after tame. And this one is 870 weight pre-tame. I'm happy. I'm very happy right now. See, this is real interesting because this guy is nearly tamed, right? This male. Oh, wait, hold on. Do we have a female in this? Male. Oh, please tell me. Is this a male or a female? It's a female. Okay, cool. So we can actually breed them. Sweet. That's awesome. Ooh, you got a level up, do you? There you go. Nice. Putting it all into weight, like you guys know. The thing about this guy, though, right? So he's been at 32 health this entire time. Bloody as all hell. From my knowledge of what I've, what I know about Ark, at least I think so, after you tame them, I think their health gets reset or something along those lines. So he's about to be tamed, I think literally right now, or it might hit the sliver, which I really hope that it doesn't. I don't know which it will, but I think all the blood is just gonna magically disappear. Let's see. Oh no, it is gonna hit the sliver, goddamn. All right, but I think the blood is gonna disappear once this happens right here. So I do actually want to see, so we're gonna hold that in for a second. Yo, check these guys out though. The horn, It's just the horn. You know what I mean? It's so incredible. Can you imagine just like, I don't know. I've never seen one in real life, obviously. But like, can you imagine seeing a creature with a horn that big in real life? Like, that would just be insane. You know what I mean? It's just like to grasp and just to feel that horn. This is becoming a bit too much of an innuendo. Anyway, so are you nearly done, Tammy, so I can get away from this conversation? Yes. So you're nearly done. 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, Tame. There we go. That was about the same name. So, yeah, right there. All the blood is immediately gone. The health is right back up to full. And we're going to go ahead and drop the new name on you. Let's see. So, let's see. Generate another name. And you're going to be Huey. Huey. All right, you know what? The names fit. The names fit. And then your weight is 900 base. That is sick. That is really, really nice right there. The melee damage is incredibly insufficient. Also, the health. 700 health on this guy. And then what about you? You're level 50. 1400 health on level 50. And then the 94 has 2000 health. Damn. So the level 94 really has some good things going for it. But this guy over here is such just like a... He's a small bean. You know what I mean? 700 HP. My god, that is just very, very minimal. Either way, time to get back home. We're going to finish off this episode. The thing that we need to do, though, is first off, locate our Quetzal. Quetzal's over here. So we got to get these guys home. That's going to be the first thing. And we need to pop saddles on all three of them. This is about to be fun. Also, I hope you guys are proud of me for having cooked meat in my inventory. I think it's actually sick. Oh, by the way, also, these guys are incredible because you know how with most dinosaurs and just most creatures in general, you can press your mouse button to tear through, what is it? Tear through a tree, just tear down a tree. These guys, if they're running up to speed, will knock down trees automatically. That's why you can hear them knocking down trees in the background. Like, listen, listen. They just knock down trees. Anything in their path, they will just obliterate. I don't know if they do that for stone, but if you turn around right now. Oh, do we lose a couple? Wait, hold on. Where's the last one? Wait, yo, Carno, Carno. Hey, Carno. Level 20 Carno. Hold up. Hold up. Hey, hey, hey. Oh my god. Wow. Yeah. These guys are going to be good for protecting. I think this is a new meta. It's getting some of these guys. Oh my god. Oh my... Oh, okay, those aren't that impressive either way, but still. Jesus, dude. Oh, it was a raptor out front. This stood literally no chance. Then we got this guy over here. Oh my god, dude. That's incredible. And now we're stuck. Are we stuck? They were stuck. Hold on. Okay, we can get out. Cool. Alright, time to unleash the horde. Also, there's for some reason stone in the middle of, I don't really rate the fact that there's just stone. Who's attacking who? Alrighty, well, on through the ruins and into your new home. Let's take a look at these guys. Oh my freaking god. That's incredible. So we got this guy over here. We got all three. We got the gang. We got the gang right here. The Quetzal seems to be kind of confused, a little dazed. I'm going to ask you to please stop. Thank you very much. I'll sit you down a little bit later. Probably don't want you flying away, though, so I'll probably have to physically sit you down. Let's go ahead and jump on you real fast here. Hop on you, and then let's just go ahead and fly you back around over to your natural spot. So we got all three of those guys just chilling down there. That is... I love that some of the dinos in this game, you know what I mean? Mammoths are awesome, but like woolly rhinos, they're like compact and just dangerous. Seriously dangerous. So let's get building up on some saddles. I think the only things that we needed, I think we have everything we need to make all the saddles, right? I believe we do. I think so. Yeah, let me check here. Rhoda wanted to come in. All right, let me see here. So if we go ahead and take a look. So saddles, and then what do we need? We need a hide. Okay. I think we've got the majority of all the hide that I need in a chest over here. Let me show you guys. I put a little chest right here down with most of our hide. Just because I feel like you always need hide on you, but I'll go ahead and take it and move it into our smithy right here. There you go. So how many of these guys can we make? We can make a total of one. What are we missing? Cementing paste. Okay. So you need a little bit more cementing paste. I think I've got more cementing paste. Where do I have cementing paste? Do I have some more in here? Oh, yeah, I've got a ton in here. Okay, cool. Cementing paste, we'll go ahead and grab those guys right over there. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. Saddles, and we can make one more. What else do we need then? We need fiber now. Okay, so now we need a little bit of fiber. I can rock with that. I can rock with that. Where's our fiber? Is our fiber contest? Do we still have some fiber in this chest? I think we do. We have 200, just enough. That's going to be good for today. All right, and drop you down right there. Saddles, and there we go. Woolly Rhino saddle. We got 3 in total. They weigh 25 a pop, I think. They weigh 20 a pop. Never mind. Ooh, hit my mic a little from there. Okay, so 1, 2, and 3. We got all 3 in our inventory. We'll go ahead and, I guess it's really the game plan is right now, drop them on, and let's see how fast these guys are. Because you guys know how with dire bears, once they catch up to speed, like, the faster that they run, the faster they'll go, and it's incredible. These guys all have 222% movement speed. They are completely stopped, though, in this little bunch of a mess. Holy crud. You guys all right? You guys all right? You've literally trapped in one of my... Oh, my God. You've literally trapped in one of my raptors. The poor thing. Guys, please. All right, here. Follow me. Follow me. And where's Charlene? Charlene, follow me, please. Thank you very much. Guys, come over here, please. Thank you. Thank you. Come on. Come on. Move away from the raptor. It's a poor little thing. We don't really need... That's a way to say hello. Oh, you knocked out my trees. Oh, no. They're going to clear up my area of all its shadows. Okay, well, that's going to be interesting. Okay, so let's go ahead and level you up and wait right there. 3, 9, 36. Saddle on top of you. Perfect. Then we'll do the same for you. There we go. Level you up and wait. Can already 1100 weight that fast. What even? What even? Why do you... Oh, my God. Level 97 already. It's incredible. And then you over here, what weight can you do? 940, and you're almost already ready for another level. All right, we'll go ahead and take that from you right there. So, I guess the game plan is I'm going to ask Charlene to stop. Thank you very much. And I'm going to ask, is that all of them? Yeah, okay, cool. So, Heidi, I believe you are the fastest of the bunch. I think they're all pretty fast. So, let's go ahead and test out. See how fast this one is. Does it catch up to speed as you run? Looks like it does. Looks like it does. I don't know if it's fast as a dire bear. It definitely doesn't have as great of a turning rate. Oh. What the fudge? Oh, yo, guys. Pay attention to the right side, right? I'm trying to, like, get in a good position. Do you guys see over on the health meter? There's, like, a little footprint. I think that's its charge ability. I'm pretty sure. Yeah, look at that right there. It's charging at the moment. And then... Oh, interesting. Okay. So I believe its charge ability is when it'll have the potential of knocking down trees out of its path. So for example, if I was to go ahead and start running through this tree right here, like right here. Oh, it hits it. Hmm. You can't just run through it, unfortunately. That kind of sucks. And it also takes away a lot of its stamina, too, from what I'm seeing here. Yeah, it drains a lot of its stamina. But I think it's actually an attack more so than it is anything else. The turning radius, obviously not as good as the dire bear. Or, yeah, dire bear. But it's still a beast of a, wow, it's incredible. So knocking down trees, some of that really drains its, yeah, you can see right there, the stamina went down very, very low, very fast. So they do definitely have their downsides, but the carry capacity, the weight they can carry makes up for it so quick. But yeah, look at the stamina goes down really fast. So they can't run as long as a dire bear. Okay, that's good to know. But apart from that, guys, then we're going to go and dip it off right there. This took a much longer time than I expected, taming up all 3 of them. Get on that weight right there, 972. It's incredible. And then I believe you already have another level right there, 974. And do you have a level on you? You don't. Okay, we got our new addition. We got Huey, we got Charlene, and Heidi. Guys, we're going to dip it off. Hopefully you all enjoyed. Drop a like if you did, and I'll catch you back tomorrow for another episode of Ark, where we can maybe do some fun things with these guys. We'll see. Ciao!